The internet first emerged in the 1960s and started catching on in the 80s and 90s, and is understandably huge today. But what if it all suddenly crashed? The internet is more than a way for seeing memes, playing games on servers, and knowing John Kasich exists, and devoting Instagram pages to one picture of him. Why does that account exist? It has also revolutionized communication to an extent horses, phones, and telegrams never could before. It also helps assist in education, gives people like me a place to work their passion, links stock traders, connects businesses, provides a nearly infinite market that not even Walmart could provide, drives US elections, and all kinds of other things. So first, how could the internet collapse? Well, it would be extremely difficult, but not impossible. If the sun released a coronal mass ejection aimed at Earth, it could potentially fry our electrical grid. But we're not interested in that much destruction, only internet, not electricity. So our phones will still work, but the internet won't. You can still play Angry Birds, but not watch this video or share it with everyone you know, which you should totally do while we still have the internet. Let's say our satellites, for whatever reason, suddenly fail and our undersea cables are cut. F***ing lobsters. The internet is, of course, not one system though, but a collection of systems. And those connections are essentially what make up the internet. But in this scenario, the connections between those systems, for whatever reason, no longer work, and therefore, the internet. Okay, so what would happen? Well, in short, people wouldn't die, but there would be a lot of confusion and panic at first. In this scenario, most phone calls and televisions also wouldn't work, though there would be ways around this, and there would still be communication around the world, just extremely limited, especially if your phone plan doesn't allow international calls. In the corporate and economic world, electronic banking services would be completely gone, and many major internet-based companies like Google, Amazon, and YouTube would also become obsolete very quickly. Because of this, unemployment rates would skyrocket. Google alone employs almost 20,000 people, and Amazon employs over 230,000 people. This would also affect more developed, more internet-friendly countries like the US, Korea, Japan, and much of Europe. Obviously, internet-unfriendly countries like Turkmenistan and the DPRK would fare better, as internet-first business is already more heavily restricted, though Kim Jong-un would have a harder time finding DC. The effects also wouldn't just be financial, as intelligence agencies would struggle, as well as any nation with a smart power grid. However, one question remains. Could the internet collapse? Well, in short, not really. To understand why, think of the internet once again as not a single physical thing, but the connections between nearly 9 billion devices that are all connected to the internet, according to Forbes in 2012. So shutting down the internet would be like destroying a country's highway network. Any realistic scenario about this would require something so catastrophic it destroys our societies before the lack of internet would. So in a way, at least right now, the collapse of the internet would be more of an economic disaster than a full-on end of the world. Thank you for watching this video, and I would also like to thank the internet for letting me make it and letting you see it. This is inspired by my friends over at Laugh Over Life and their Day the Internet Died skit, which I was almost in as a newscaster, but they lost the footage. But either way, you should totally watch it. Link in the description. If you want to see more, please be sure to like, share, and subscribe. See you on Wednesday, and stay positive.